when they look at you and what it costs to live at the heart of this, they'll wonder at it. They'll wonder at you. They should.
President Abraham Lincoln was a statesman, a highly effective military leader, but we basically concentrated our story on Lincoln's political skills. Lincoln never lost the ability to make things happen through compromise. The thing he had the most faith in was the democratic process. And when it's working, it can bring about revolutionary changes, especially when you're a leader like Lincoln, who listened to and believed in the people. We focused only on the last 4 months of Lincoln's life because we wanted to show Lincoln accomplishing something great, something really monumental, and that was abolishing slavery and ending the Civil War. We also wanted to show that he was a man, not a monument. And our best hope of understanding and doing justice to this immensely complicated person was to depict his fight to pass the 13th Amendment on the floor of the House of Representatives.
Congress must never declare equal those whom God created unequal.
You're going to try to pass the amendment to abolish slavery. No one's loved as much as you by the people. Don't waste that power.
By choosing the last 4 months of the war, you get not only a beginning, a middle, and end to an incredibly thrilling question of whether the 13th Amendment is going to pass the Congress, but it also means that Lincoln has to weigh in his soul that the war might be extended as a result of this process. He knows that that's important for the long run, but everybody who dies in the meantime, he has to feel as a personal responsibility.
Think of all the boys who'll die if you don't make peace.
Lincoln first signed the Emancipation Proclamation as a war document. The only reason it was legal was that he could argue that slaves were being used by the Confederates to help in the military battles.
The Emancipation Proclamation was handy at the time. It was very shaky, even of questionable legality.
Once the war came to an end, what would happen to the slaves? Then he knew the next phase had to be the 13th Amendment.
A lot of people think that the Emancipation Proclamation was the greatest act of Lincoln's political life. But the 13th Amendment was one of the most important events in American history, because what's more important than abolishing slavery for all time?
I can't end this war until we cure ourselves of slavery. This amendment is that cure.
The script deals with the machinations of a moment in history, of what it took. The back rooms, the wheelings and dealings, the compromises, all that went into pushing through one of the most important amendments to the Constitution ever. The long view that he had was something very few people can live with. Does the end justify the means?
A lot of people lost their lives to get that amendment passed. It is a very interesting story.
These votes must be procured.
Congressman, come cheap. A few $1,000 will buy all you need.
We can't buy the votes.
Let me see what you can do.
Did Lincoln overreach his authority as president? There are certainly gray areas in the balance of powers. Lincoln stretched these powers in unprecedented ways, and he occasionally went beyond where he knew the courts would follow. I think there's an argument to whether some or all of what he did was actually necessary, though we believe history's verdict declines in Lincoln's favor.
Abolishing slavery settles the fate for the millions now in bondage, and unborn millions to come.
When you watch the way in which Lincoln finessed the question of slavery, you see somebody who, with a kind of unbelievable mastery, understands how to move the population through talking and through legislation and action.
It's the man himself that invites you, because he was so open, and that was one of the most beautiful surprises. It was him that put me at my ease and gave me the thought that, well, maybe I could try to do this.
Today we will vote.
You insult God!
A fight like this is to the death.
Yes!
I am the President of the United States, clothed in immense power!